Hi, just be with you one moment. Talk to August. How are you? Good. So, you're here for your cranial nerve examination. Is that correct? Okay. I've just got some health questions to ask you just before we begin. Just want to double check whether you have registered front desk. Okay. So the questions that I'm asking you here are going to be for my use only, and they will not be shared with anyone unless I have your permission. Okay. So let me start with your name. Very nice to meet you. Right, so today's what's your surname? Date of birth? And your address? What was the city? Okay. Postcode. And your telephone number. Sorry. Start that again. Right, okay. And your current occupation? Okay. And your email address? So is that .co.uk or .com? Okay. So, who is your next of kin? What's her name? And their relationship to you? Okay. And their mobile number, or best number to contact them on? You're entitled to a chaperone today. Just let me know if you would like one and I can have the reception arranged for you. Okay. And do you currently have any aids at all? So wheelchair, walking aid, hearing aid? And just a very brief medical history, if that's okay. So, do you suffer or have you suffered from any of the following conditions? If yes, since when? So, heart disease, stroke, okay. Cancer, okay. Diabetes, asthma. Okay, high blood pressure. Right. Epilepsy. Okay, and high cholesterol. Okay, and have you had any operations in the past 5 years? And how long ago was that? Alright. Has that cleared up now? Okay. Are you currently taking any medicine? And how long have you been taking those? Any allergies? Okay. Did you take anything for that? No. Okay, and just some questions on your lifestyle now. This is all just protocol. Once I have finished asking you questions, I'll go in to do the assessment. So if you have any questions, just feel free to stop me and I'll be happy to answer. Okay. So your smoking status: never smoked, ex-smoker or current smoker? And do you take regular exercise? Okay. Right, so I'm just going to go into your family medical history now. So has a member of your immediate family, father, mother, siblings and grandparents, had or suffered from any of the following? Heart attack, cancer, diabetes, high blood pressure. Okay. Do you care for a vulnerable older person or a vulnerable person? Okay. So I've just got to read this for you. It's just based on your medical information. So health professionals are trained to keep your records secure and to manage them responsibly and in confidence. There are several models for sharing data, which have all been put into place nationally and locally in different areas. Please see the data sharing table, which shows what information is shared. Share your records because you therefore won't need to repeat your medical history, avoid unnecessary appointments, and make sure that I have all the correct information all the time. You have the right to remove your data from our database, and you also have the right to view your personal file and your records. That's just your right. So do you consent? Okay. Okay, can I just get your signature? I'd like to know a little bit about why you're here today. So, cranial nerve exam is an exam that we use to test all of the different cranial nerves in the body. And what this tells us is whether they're healthy and whether there are any underlying conditions, especially if you do have any symptoms. The cranial nerve exam is there to help me work out what could be wrong. So I guess the first question would be, have you experienced any pain anywhere? In the face, the neck, back of the throat, around the eyes? Okay. And what about headaches? Do you have migraines? Okay. So in a minute I'm going to examine your cranial nerves. There may be points where you're a little bit confused as to why I'm doing what I'm doing. So if you do have any questions or you'd like to know what I'm assessing, and I will try my best to talk you through when I'm doing it, please feel free to stop me and just ask the question and I'll be happy to help. So there are also moments when I might need to touch your face. Are you happy for me to do that? And so I might be touching you, but I will use gloves. And I think that's just about everything. Do you have any questions? Okay. Great. So make sure that there's no hair in your face and that your clothes are tucked away. Great, okay. So I'm going to test the first cranial nerve, which is your olfactory nerve. So have you had any changes to your sense of smell recently? Okay. Just going to get you to have a smell of this, and I'd just like you to tell me what you can smell. Okay. Yes, rose. Well done. So now I'm going to test your second cranial nerve, which is the cranial nerve that is responsible for your vision. So for this, I'm just going to be having a look at the size and symmetry of your pupils. So all I'd like you to do is just look straight at me. I'm just going to be looking at my guide and comparing it to your pupils, okay? So just look straight at me. The next part of the test, I'd like you to just look at this chart here, and I'd like you to just, if you could start at the beginning and working your way down, just read the letters out to me. Try and see if you can go as low as line number 9, but if you can't, sniff, okay? Try this one. Still looking at your second cranial nerve, I'm just going to be testing your reflexes now, your pupil reflexes. So I'd just like you to cover one eye for me. Okay. And you don't have to do anything apart from look at my nose. Okay. So for this test, I'd like you to just follow the light with your eyes, okay? going to just look at the accommodation of your eye, so I'm just going to be looking at how it sits in the eye, anything around it, any abnormalities. I'm going to be coming a little bit closer. Okay.
Okay, so that's
look straight at me. Okay. The next part of the test, still looking at your second cranial nerve, I'd like you just to take a look at this chart here. So there are two numbers, okay? Firstly, I'd just like you to tell me what the top number is. Okay, and the second number. And just looking at the first number again, can you describe the colours of the actual numbering? Okay, and then the outer colours. Okay, and then the second one, can you describe the colours inside? And then the outer circle of colours. Okay. A little bit of info about this test. I'm looking at whether you can recognise the numbers inside, because people may have an issue actually seeing what number that is. As you can see, kind of greeny blue inside. On its own, it's actually a number one. But if you look at the rest of the number in a light green colour, it makes up the number four. And then again, we have something similar here where it is a number three, but due to the differences in colours, some people may have problems understanding what number that is. Okay. Okay, for the next test, your visual second cranial nerve, I'm just going to be testing your visual fields, okay? So I'd like you to tell me when you can see my fingers. Okay? Okay. Okay. One hand over one eye. I'm just going to do the same process again. Just place a hand over the other eye. Okay, same thing again. Third cranial nerve now. So I'm just going to check for any drooping of the eye. Okay. Just look up for me. Okay, and blink. And just close both of your eyes. Your eyes, there is a slight droop. I'd like to find out if you weren't born with that. Yep, then that's fine. Okay. I'm just going to test your eye movements now. So I'd like you to look this way. Do now is I'm just going to place my hand over one of your eyes and I'm just going to test your reflexes after I move my hand. Okay. So next, I'm going to test your trigeminal nerve. Now this nerve sits here, and it has branches that come off all over the face, like so. And some people may experience pain in their trigeminal nerve that shoots over the face. So sometimes people might describe having electric shock type pains on their face, and that would suggest that there may be something wrong with their trigeminal nerve. Okay, so all I'm going to do is press around the trigeminal nerve, and I'd like you to tell me if that triggers any pain. Okay, I'm going to go on the other side as well. Just tell me if you feel any pain. I'm going to now test some of the muscles in your face, and all I'm going to do is press your face in certain areas, and I'd just like you to tell me if it hurts at all. Okay. We have a muscle in our jaw that can be connected to different parts of the brain, so if we feel pain in one area, it might be due to the fourth cranial nerve. I'm going to place my hand underneath your chin, and I'd just like you to force your mouth open, and I'm going to try and push back, okay? Yep. Excellent. So next I'd like you to slightly open your mouth like so, okay, and I'm going to tap between your lower lip and your chin, and I'm trying to instigate your jaw reflex, okay? The next test is to check your corneal reflex, but I'm not going to do this one today because it does involve me pressing your eye to see if you do blink. I'm not going to do this today because I don't have any concerns that there's going to be an issue with it, and I'd rather not put you through the discomfort. I'm gonna move on. Okay. Right. So I'm gonna test your facial movements now. So if you could just repeat the facial expressions that I'm doing. Okay. So. going to inspect your ears, okay? This is part of the cranial nerve, it's not a hearing test. I am just going to be looking for any redness, and I am going to be pulling on your ear as well. Sometimes that can trigger pain, and that's important to pick that up, okay? So I'm just going to have a look on this side first. Okay, I'm just slightly pulling on the ear now. Please let me know if you feel anything. Okay. And now on the other eye, I'm just going to be looking inside the ear. On the other ear, sorry. And now on the other ear, I'm doing the same. Discomfort. Okay. Have you had any changes in your hearing recently? And any changes in your taste? So what I mean by that is, have you been getting like a metallic taste in the mouth at all? Okay. And the food tastes the same? Okay, I'm just going to make some noises in your ear. I'd just like you to tell me if you can hear it. I'd just like you to move your head to this side, to the middle, to this side, to the middle, okay? You can do it now. Okay, great, thank you. Now I'm going to be having a look at your glossopharyngeal nerve. So again, the same as trigeminal nerve. People can experience pain at the back of their throat and at their trigeminal nerve simultaneously. This type of pain is called neuralgia. So you could have trigeminal neuralgia or you could have glossopharyngeal neuralgia. So I'm going to look at the back of your throat, and I'm just going to be seeing if there's any kind of infection or redness or anything that could suggest any cause of pain at all. Okay. So if you could just open your mouth. Okay. Okay. problems with swallowing. Okay, now, slightly weird one, but can you cough for me? Okay. And can you swallow? I'd like you to shrug your shoulders against the resistance of my abs, okay? And again. Good. And now I'd like you to turn your head to this side against my resistance. Okay, and now to this side. Perfect. Very last one I'd like to test is your tongue. So if you could open your mouth, and I'm just going to have a look at your tongue while your mouth is rested. Okay. And I'd like you to protrude your tongue as much as you can. Any pain? Okay. Alright, well thank you. That's the end of the assessment. I'm just going to review the notes and discuss any concerns that I have. Okay. Your taste was good, yeah. Closer examination, just on your pupils, just to make sure. So I will send all my findings to you. So other than that, we are finished. If you have any questions?